rush is here to stop me. Unfortunately, you've come too late. I've already raised Tryloth, and it is heading toward the city as we speak. But truth be told, I have been waiting for an opportunity to meet you. Yes, yes, what else is new? Now let me tell you a little story, I'm sure. After defeating Shadowmaga here in this very place 20 years ago, ever since has led me to this point. I am going to stop Archimedes, and you will stay here with Trin. And believe me, I will make sure that you do. Very well. Let us see the man that you become. Come and face me, knight. Potential son. Too bad it's wasted carrying a sword instead of a staff.
Ha 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 ha
Congratulations, you defeated me. Or should I say, one of me. My apparition. Even though I enjoy spending time with you, son, I cannot let this go on any longer.
Did he get away? Don't worry, we'll get him later. Now it's time to get out of here.
Everything you have told me proves that Archimedes distanced himself from common sense a long time ago. He will never stand down. He's too old and too blind to appreciate what he has already accomplished. A girl and an old lady are playing in a garden, laughing. Go fetch your grandpa, Trin, Calliope says.
Oh, now go fetch your grandpa, Trin.
Trin runs into the shadowy laboratory of Archimedes. There is a store cube on the table, glowing in blue light, and it catches Trin's attention. She reaches for it, and when her finger touches it, it opens up. Archimedes sees her and speaks in wonder. All it needed was the touch of an awoken one. Holographic blueprints of the Grand Corps float in the room, showing a spaceship leaving the surface, heading towards a vessel in Gaia's orbit. Archimedes rushes to tell Calliope what he has just found out. Calliope rests in the garden, surrounded by the most beautiful flowers Gaia has to offer. There is a single star-shaped flower on her still hand, and the death of Calliope changed him forever. To the palace. Let's go.